subscribe to our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get the latest updates.
Billions of cicadas belonging to a group called Brood 10 have started to emerge from underground to chirp, feast, mate, and die across the states along the east of the United States of America. These kind of cicadas are periodic cicadas. They have a life cycle of either 13 or 17 years, depending on species. And they live mostly underground in the early stage of their development. They emerge after 13 or 17 years and remain above the ground for a mere few weeks. In this video, let's explore the phenomenon of cicada emergence, why it is of such a scientific significance, what cicadas do underground for so long, why they have such an unusual life cycle, and the growing concerns on their life cycle as well as numbers caused by climate change. I'm Sandhya Ramesh and this is Pure Science. What are cicadas? They're mistakenly called locusts, but they're not locusts or grasshoppers. They don't actually jump or hop, instead they fly. Cicadas come in over 3,000 species and are found on all continents except Antarctica. All of them have different life cycles. The ones that are emerging right now are periodic cicadas. There are also annual cicadas that emerge every year. These insects are conspicuously loud, with calls being produced exclusively by males for courtship and mating. Their life cycle is divided into stages of eggs, the nymph stage, metamorphosis, and adult. They have an adult lifespan of 2 months at the most. When an egg hatches in leaves or in barks of trees, the immature form of the insect, which is called a nymph, drops to the ground. It has strong front legs, so it uses these front legs to burrow into the ground, and it can go up to depths of 8 feet, 2 meters. Cicada nymphs are thought to live at depths below 2 meters, and they also dig aeration tunnels and exit tunnels for their survival and subsequent emergence. As they're starting to emerge, what they first do is they climb up on trees or plants and they start to shed or molt their outer skin. This abandoned skin is actually an exoskeleton, and when cicadas molt, they do this 3 to 4 times, the abandoned exoskeleton actually remains stuck to plants and trees. So when it's the time for cicadas to emerge, in the regions that they emerge, people can often find tree barks and plant stems covered with discarded exoskeletons of cicadas. After molting 3 to 4 times, their wings are fully formed and they're ready to fly. They have weak legs, so they're not good jumpers. Their hind legs are really weak. They also do not move well on their feet at all, so they're weak runners and walkers as well. And even if they have to move very short distances, they prefer flying. Both nymphs, which live underground, as well as adults, which fly and live above ground, drink plant sap. Nymphs directly drink from the roots of the trees. They get their water and nutrients by actually tapping into the xylem inside a plant. A xylem, if we remember our high school biology, is actually the transport tissue that a plant uses to transport water and nutrients from its roots to leaves for photosynthesis. Adult cicadas are very loud. As soon as they emerge, they start their loud chorus, and this is of course all of the males doing the chirping. This signals males starting to congregate, and they're either waiting where they are for females to come to them, or they all start to fly and start to look for females to mate with. Once mating is done, the female cicada lays her eggs on leaves or tree barks, but she does this by first carving a groove on the structure of the leaf or the tree bark, and then depositing her eggs into this area. Of course, the leaves and branches are damaged and eventually they will wilt and brown and die. While cicadas do this, damage leaves and barks and also tap into roots and cover plants with their molted skin, they're actually not considered a major threat to vegetation as they're starting to emerge. The time they start to damage plants is when they start laying eggs in plants. Most mature plants can withstand some amount of damage to leaves and barks, but younger plants tend to be more susceptible and do require protection when it's time for cicadas to emerge. Brood 10, or the Great Eastern Brood, is one of the 15 broods of cicadas that appear periodically in the eastern United States. Brood 10 consists of the largest number of individuals, and it also covers the greatest geographical range of habitat. There are other broods as well. Different broods emerge at different times, and they are also highly localized to specific geographical locations within their habitat range. So brood 1 emerges on a different periodic cycle at a different location than brood 2, and so on. Brood 10 emergences have been documented since 1715, and they occur every 17 years. The one before this was in 2004, and the one after this is expected to occur in 2038. Entomologists, or experts who study insects, have been growing concerned with early emergences of individuals from brood 10, with some emergence appearing 4 years early, both in 2017 and earlier in 2000. Experts think that climate change plays a contributing role, because cicadas actually tend to emerge when the ground becomes about 17 to 18 degrees Celsius, or 64 degrees Fahrenheit. The curious 13 and 17 year life cycles of cicadas has been the subject of much research. We're yet to understand exactly why this number has come to be what it is, 13 or 17, but there are multiple theories. It is primarily thought to be a response to predators. Cicadas are eaten by most animals that eat insects, including birds, rodents, bats, spiders, and so on. When adults emerge in such large numbers, they're also then immediately eaten by other animals, like other fish and reptiles and even humans, because it's an opportunity to feast. Most of these animals and these predators eat most other insects. But some predators specialize in preying on cicadas specifically, such as cicada killer wasps or even praying mantises. These specialist species are, of course, a higher threat to cicada populations. So one of the theories states that this bizarre 17 and 13 year life cycles came about as a response to combat the threat of these predators, which have a typical life cycle of less than 2 years or so. Because their life cycle is so short, these predators cannot rely on cicada populations for prey. There's another theory also. This says that cicadas evolved such long life cycles during the ice ages or glaciation periods in the past in Earth's history, so that they could survive periods of deep freeze and extreme cold. Most animals and most insects would have done this, and as the earth warmed, cicada predators, who also would have adapted similar strategies, started to emerge more regularly and have a life cycle of their own and have a peak in numbers periodically. To prevent their own populations from peaking while other predator populations are also peaking in cyclical numbers, cicadas are thought to have evolved to peak in intervals of prime numbers. Cicadas have also evolved a number of anti-predator protections. They're well camouflaged and blend into barks of trees thanks to their colored bodies and transparent wings. They're able to both play dead as well as engage in startle display, where they perform flashy displays with their colored hind wings, and this startles or scares predators and they can escape. The ones that are not camouflaged to blend in often tend to be unusually brightly colored. These colors, bright colors, actually attract predator attention, and they actually advertise to predators that the animal is toxic and the predator should stay away. Cicadas are not actually poisonous to their predators, and their bright colors are only an imitation of a warning signal by actual poisonous or venomous animals. So these behaviors are a form of mimicry, and this kind of mimicry, where something which is not a predator assumes the warning signals of a predator, is known as Batesian mimicry. Since cicada emergence attracts the brief opportunistic attention of nearly every predator around, the insects combat their loss in numbers by actually raising their numbers. This is called predator satiation and is a reproduction strategy where even after every predator has had its fill, there are still enough cicadas to carry on mating and perpetuating the species.